गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय सदा जय भक्ताय सदभक्ताय नमो यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेक्षकृत्यं द्वैताय विरहकाचलयः तवैवास्मि आमित्वया विना शिविज्ञाय राधे तन्मा
Vedanta Swami Maharaj. I am preaching here and there in whole world. A special mercy He showered on me. So, I am also praying in His lotus feet. You know that how in a couple of years He came from India and preached over whole world. Wrote so many books, translated so many authentic books, established so many preacher centers here and there, and in couple of years, in whole world, even in ocean islands like this Hawaii, also on the mountains, in Saranagati, here and there, and also so many countries, everywhere. Even in Muslim countries also, in South Africa also, in the whole world he established. So quickly, what he came to this world, descended to this world, why? To help you all. Also he sent me, or to help you all. But if you are not taking that help, that is mercy, then you are what? More wretched than animals, hogs, pigs, dogs and all. All you should remember all this. Oh, they are happy more than you are. Instant gratifications and so many things. Oh, they can give birth. Oh, not only one child, but several. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, thousands of children they can give in one month. So you are not anyhow superior to them. That has no trouble like you. Always so many problems. They are not facing. If I have one child or two child, one lady in India, girl, then how I should maintain it? But for them. So when about 5,000 years before, all the learned rishi and realized rishi who realized Brahma Tattva, Krishna also, they were assembled anywhere in India, in Naimisharanya, very good forest, on the bank of a river. Not only one alone, they were assembled about 8,000 of Rishi Maharshi, realized souls. And they were discussing. What discussion? That now it is of Kali Yuga, irony is here. Kali Kalaham Lati. Without any reason, so many kinds of problems will come, burning each other, without no reason at all. Prayena alpa ayushaha, sabya klarsvin yuge jana, mandasu manda matayo manda bhagyayi upadrita. In this iron age, Kali Yuga, all have so much less small longevity, long life, short life, manda, all are unfortunate. Sumanda matayo, not intelligent. Not intelligent. Manda bhagya. No fortune. Upadrita. Always problems like waves. One after another problems come. And they had to do so many things. Very busy life. How busy life? Like dogs, very busy, running on the road, highway, four wheels. Where are you going? Oh, I have no time to speak to you. I'm very busy. And they will go run up to a milestone. Milestone, you know? Milestone. And they will make urine. And they will return again. Where you are going, I have no time to answer you. So we are all busy fire bees. Why you are doing all these things? A businessman, man, by disciple, oh very wealthy, he went to Italy, a very high topic of any businessman there. And he was, what, crores, dollars coming, income daily and going. And he was so much busy. My disciple, also businessman, he asked him, oh, why you are doing all these things? Will you take anything, any farthing of any pence, shilling of this, when you will die? Even your these hairs? He told them, I have not. I will die and what will be after my death? And he became like mad. What you are earning in this life by this body and this intelligence, you should know they all will be in this world. Your this body also, but transformation will be, it will be ashes or what? Stool of animal. So what to do? You should realize this thing. What you are doing whole day long, can you take it with you after your death or not? If anyone will take, they can raise their hand that I will take all these things. Can you? Your father? Your mother? Your friends? You should know all these things. You cannot take anything, even a particle of dust, from you. Then why you are doing all things? Or to be happy, or you cannot be happy by this. More problems will come. So they are discussing each other how to be happy, how our soul will be happy. Ruhina sadda dananan jenatma samprasiddhati. Not this body. Actually, we are not this body. I know in our group, that devotee sitting there, she is more aged. She may be of 60. 60? About? 60? 60. One day, she was more beautiful than you. Very beautiful. Always a smiling face. Very attractive and sweet, I know. My age is also above 80. So beautiful. But now, and after 10 years, yes, after 20 years, what will be? She cannot walk. She can walk with anything. And after some time, she will put to death. She cannot take anything. You cannot take. So you all be old. Anyone cannot stop this. So how we can be happy? Oh, not this body. This body also and soul also. You should know that you are not this material body. You are part and parcel of Supreme Personality of Godhead, that is Krishna. An eternal servant of Krishna. But anyhow, you have forgotten this. You have come to this world controlled by Maya. You cannot be happy in this world. This world is made by problems only. How you can? If you want to be happy in jail, understand me?
Yes.
If you want to be happy in jail, you are foolish. All foolish. Jail has made to punish stupid nonsense persons. Who are violating rules and regulations. So, that is the place of punishment. How you can be happy? So, this place is made of. You can only be happy by what? Savai punsan paro dharmo jato bhakti rathok kage ahet utkam pratitata jayatma sam. You can only be happy by chanting, remembering, singing the glories of Supreme Personality of God. This is our really first religion, constitutional function. Not this thing. You are always engaged in sense gratification for so many things, but really you cannot be happy. If even one name of Krishna enters in your ears, or you are chanting and remembering the glories of Krishna, you must be happy. Without chanting you cannot be, but he can be only heard by whom? Guru. Transcendental Guru. Holy Master. Perhaps you know all the name of Brahmaji. Brahma. He was created by Vishnu, Mahavishnu, to create this world. When he was created Brahma, we saw everywhere, oh, water, water, water. And very dark, nothing was there, only dark. What should I do? They could not imagine even. Then a sound came, aerial came, spark, tapa, tapa. And then, how to tapa? He was meditating and remembering his holy master, Mahavishnu. From where I have come? I am offering thousands and thousands of prayers to that personality. And then, at once he heard something. Oh, that aerial voice, Daivavani, told that mantra of Krishna, Kling Krishnaya. And you should chant this for a long time. And then your heart will be pure. Then I will do something more. He did so, and after so many long periods, thousands and thousands of years, when the purification of our heart was done, oh, from the flute of Krishna, he heard Kama Gayatri. And by that Kama Gayatri, he knew so many glories of Krishna, and then he was praying. That is Brahma Sanskrita. Very good Vishnu. So without Guru, we cannot be happy. But we'll have to have very strong faith on his word. You know, Dhruva. You know Dhruva Maharaj? Perhaps you don't know. You? Oh, Dhruva was a son of very high class of king, emperor of whole world. And when he was in the age of 5, he wanted to sit in the lap of his father. But for the fear of the state mother, he could not take his lap. Stepmother told, you cannot sit in the lap of your father. If you will die and take birth in my home, then you can sit. Otherwise, not. So I began to weep loud, very loud, and came to his mother. Mother told, why you are weeping? Oh, my father did not took me in his lap. Why you are weeping? Oh. Your Prabhu is Hari, Krishna, Supreme Personality of Godhead. You should try to please him. And by that, if he will be pleased, by his mercy, you can be the king of whole world, whole universe. Oh, where is he? Oh, in the midnight, without telling her mother, and oh, 5-year-old boy, Dhruva, left his father, mother, everything. And in the night, dark night, he went to Mathura. And he was thinking how to please my father, Prabhu Krishna. If anyone tries like this, Krishna helps them. So he sent Narada, oh, you should hear all, very attentively. If anyone wants to serve Krishna or to meet Krishna, to have a darshan of Krishna, really he wants, then what happens? Krishna himself sends his associate to them, to help. So he sent Narada Rishi to Dhruva. He came and he tested him, what he wants really. Dhruva told him that I want to have a darshan of Sri Hari and I want to be the emperor of all this world. He told him that you should return to your home, so many lions and tigers will eat you. Oh, you should not be here, you are a very small boy. You should return. But he told that I have decided to do or die. So I must please Sri Hari. Then Narada gave him diksha, a mantra. Oh, you should do. And in very soon, you can have a darshan of or Sri Hari. And what he did? What he did? Oh, should hear.
So after receiving instructions from the great sage Narada Muni and receiving that powerful mantra of Lord Hari, the small boy Dhruva would obey.
The young boy Dhruva, he sat down to chant that mantra with great absorption. What he did, he sat on a hilltop and he concentrated his mind, and gradually, one after another, he left his connection with all the gross matter. What was the first thing? He gave up all the eating, all the solid food, and he only kept on liquids or water. And then, after a month or so, he even gave up that and he was simply living on air. After that, after some months living on air, he even gave up taking air. He was not even breathing. So, you can hear me? So after that, what happened? At about, after 6 months, when he was deeply meditating on the wonderful form of the Lord, as described in the mantra by Narada Muni, what happened? He saw that the beautiful form of the Lord from his heart disappeared. And he was so much disturbed. What happened? I had that beautiful form of the Lord in my heart and now it's not there anymore. So when he was disturbed, he opened his eyes and he saw that very Lord was standing in front of him. But young boy, only 5 years old, so he knew nothing how to act, how to reciprocate with the Lord himself. So mercifully, Sri Narayan, he touched his conch shell with the head of this boy. And as soon as this conch shell touched his forehead, all the knowledge and conclusion of all the Vedas manifested in his heart. He knew all the prayers, wonderful, beautiful prayers in Sanskrit, and they started glorifying the Lord. And after he had done so, the Lord was so much pleased upon him and he said that, okay, now I am very much pleased. So you shall ask what your all desires shall be fulfilled now. But at this point, because of the mercy of the Lord and his personal association, what has happened? The young boy has realized that what he was desiring for was simply useless. He was looking for a broken piece of glass. And what he has achieved? He has achieved a diamond. But now, because he had performed all that austerities, he has performed all that worship with the desire to be materially successful, to have a great kingdom, even more greater than his father. So the Lord said, your desire must be fulfilled because you worship me with that desire. So here is a very important point for all of us who are pursuing spiritual life, that we should be very careful with our inspiration within. Despite performing all the process or all the following all the limbs of bhakti, if within the heart our desire is to enjoy or to have any material desire fulfilled, then what will happen? By the mercy of the mantra or the process of devotional service, our desires will keep getting fulfilled and we will not meet our goal and we will keep delaying. And then it might happen that we may lose interest because we may see that our desires are not getting fulfilled. But the reason is not the weakness of the process, but is our own weakness. So, when the Lord told him that now I bless you to have this, but do not worry, because you have attained my mercy, my blessings. So what will happen? You will not be afflicted by this material influence. You will rule the entire earth for 36,000 years. And after that you will come to my abode, a very special abode called Dhruva Loka. And we also see some in the sky, the famous star, which is always shining so much, glittering and luminous. And after that, you will come and attain my bhakti. So this is how the young boy, because of his determination and great faith in the words of his Gurudev, he attained his goal of life.
If you are like Dhruva a transcendental guru was sent by himself Krishna. Why? Because his desire was so strong that I may die but no harm. I want to please Krishna. But if your desire is like so, Krishna will send such class of it. And that is why Swamiji came to this world. There were so many very interested persons, sincere persons who wanted to be always happy and to serve Krishna. So Krishna himself sent him. And that is why. Again, also, he is sending me only for this, to help others. So our desire should be like this. Then a guru like him, you can help. Otherwise, if your desire is not as strong, then what doing? Oh, guru will be received like that. And in a day, they will fall down 3-4 times. Not as strong, not knowing all the siddhanta and stuff. Very weak. And then we will start from where? Even one round in whole day. This is very long process. If a boy, a student, is admitted in a school the whole day. He plays football, volleyball, cricket, drinking, merry-making here and there. Whole day, whole year. What will be? Nothing. If sometimes he study this course, or it may be that of so many years he may pass first class, otherwise. So we should try to be like Dhruva. He gave his whole attention, his whole energy in the remembering his deity. How? Even not eating. Not eating anything delicious preparation, not drinking so many juices,
not taking anything, cigarette or smoking even. What doing? In 15 days, or dry leaves of trees, very little, anyhow. And water, only one, two times. And after this second or third month, he left everything, even leaves and water also. Only taking air, and another month, he left air also, and he became in samadhi. And Krishna was bound to give him darshan. But I tell you that even one time, one round you should do no harm. I tell you not to take cigarettes, flesh, or cows, beef, all these bad things. Wine, you should not take. It will spoil your life. So you should try to realize this. Don't take all these things. Try to observe four regulative principles. And chant, even chanting one round, what will be? Oh, you can have the darshan of Krishna, you can be happy, but it is very long process. But the process of Prahlad Maharaj, process of Dhruva, the process of Raghunath Das Goswami, oh, in one life you can have it, even in one life. But try to be, at least like Raghunath Das Goswami. What is the story of Raghunath Das Goswami? Can you tell?
In brief.
Srila Raghunath Das Goswami lived in this world about 500 years ago. He was the son of a very rich, aristocratic landlord. And this family had only one son. There were two brothers who were so rich that they earned millions of gold coins. Yeah, at that time, we can imagine how much the value is now. So wealthy they were. And they had only one son. But you can imagine, if you have only one son, how fond you are of that one son. So Raghunath, from his early age, he received the association of great sadhus. He received the association of Haridas Thakur and Yadunandan Acharya. Due to the influence of this association, his desire to serve Krishna, to meet Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, became so strong by hearing from his spiritual master and Srila Haridas Thakur. He developed such a strong desire to meet with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that no other interest, whatever was there in his surrounding, due to being the only son in such a rich, wealthy, aristocratic family, you can imagine how much he was surrounded by the objects of the senses. But his desire to meet Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and to serve Krishna was so strong that he was not at all interested in anything else. So his father and mother, they were worried. They thought, our Raghunath, he has become mad. He tries always to find any way to meet with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Actually, at some point, he met with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And by the influence of that meeting, he became so much, you may say, attracted to give up material life altogether, that he received that special mercy from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu told him, when he came to meet with him for the first time, that very soon, yeah, you will attain my lotus feet, but now you should go back to your family and behave just like an ordinary person. Don't upset your family members, but in your heart always meditate on me and always meditate on Krishna. So Raghunath Das Goswami, Raghunath at this stage, later on Raghunath Das Goswami, followed the instruction of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu said, don't be a madman. Don't run here and there looking for Krishna, but be patient, desire to meet with Krishna, and very soon your desire will be fulfilled. Krishna will make all the arrangements. So his father and mother thought, oh Raghunath, yeah, we shall somehow or other try to keep him with us. We shall marry him with a very beautiful girl. Yeah. Then he will not leave us. Yeah. But father told mother, listen, now we have married our son with this beautiful girl, but still he wants to always go and meet with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So what to do? We cannot bind him. We cannot keep him with us. Yeah. So Raghunath, he became so much fortunate that Krishna made the arrangement that one night his spiritual master, Yadunandana Acharya, he came to the house of Raghunath's family and he told Raghunath, please come with me, I have some service for you. And even though the house was guarded by so many servants and watchmen that Raghunath could not go anywhere, father and uncle, they had so much faith in Yadunandana Acharya that Raghunath can go with him, he will come back. Actually, his father and uncle were very pious. They were looking after all the Vaishnavas in Navadvip, yeah, supplying them with so many things for their maintenance. They were very wealthy and pious both, and they were thinking, Raghunath should just be like us. He should not go to Mahaprabhu and give up this family life. It is so good. So that night, by Krishna's mercy, this arrangement was made that Raghunath came with Yadunandana Acharya to do some special service, pujari service. The pujari had left on the pretext of that. Raghunath left his family and he told his spiritual master, listen, Guruji, I will do this service. You can go to your ashram. Don't worry. I will manage everything. So at that time, Raghunath was thinking, oh, Krishna is so merciful. Now quickly, I should go to Puri, where Mahaprabhu is. So Raghunath ran day and night without thinking about eating or sleeping or drinking, and very soon he reached the lotus feet of Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu was so happy to meet with Raghunath Das that he bestowed some very special mercy upon him. He gave him in the care of Sarup, Sri Sarup Damodar. So this is, in short, the history of Raghunath Das Goswami. If we can be like this, then our success in Krishna consciousness is guaranteed. If we can develop this one-pointedness, only desiring to serve Krishna, to meet with Krishna, to be in the association of pure Vaishnavas, then very quickly we will see Krishna will make all the arrangements. So, again, we should pray that this mercy may come in our life, this very special mercy. And that is why our acharyas, like Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, and now our Gurudev, Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj, is coming to the West to kindle this desire within our hearts, to develop this very strong eagerness. How can I serve Krishna? How can I please Krishna? How can I learn from these examples, especially the example of Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, to take full shelter in the association of sadhus?
this morning Srila Gurudev said, we have no so strong faith that Krishna will protect us and nourish us. We think, oh, we have to protect ourselves and nourish ourselves. We think, oh, Krishna, he may be interested or not, but actually, when we have this strong conviction, Krishna is nourishing the whole world, all living entities, the animals, the trees, they don't have to work like us to nourish our bodies, our families. So why should we be so much worried? We should develop this strong conviction that surrendering to the lotus feet of Sadguru, coming in the association of pure Vaishnavas, this will solve all our problems. Not only that, but this will give us real happiness and real life, which is to serve the lotus feet of the divine couple under the guidance of Guru and Vaishnavas.
Without high class of association, we cannot have pure bhakti. A person who has himself not expert in bhakti, some realization that is told in Srimad Bhagavatam, tasmat gurum prapatyeta jigyasu seya uttamam shabde parecha nishanatam brahman upasamasne. If one has realized this fact, that by these activities that I am doing, we cannot be happy. Never. So to know how I can be happy really in this world and after this world, that world. Then we should go to very high class of devotee, realize, knowing all the purport of Shastra, Gita, Bhagavata, Ramayana, and really observing themselves, himself, following all what it has been told. So he should be expert in all these siddhants of Ved, Upanishad, Bhagavata, Ramayana. And secondly, he should have some realization of Krishna. If anyone is expert in all Shastra, but no realization of Krishna, oh, he is not. After some time he may fall down. And if anyone not knowing even so much Shastra, but realization of Krishna, really he is. But one thing more, he will be detached from worldly desires and worldly attachments. He must be. If the Guru is not detached by worldly things, he has no experience, he has not realized anything from Krishna, and he is not knowing all this basic siddhanta, really he is not. By association, you cannot do all this. You cannot have all these things. So Guru should be like this. Fortunately, if you have a Guru like this, or detached from worldly matters, totally, always chanting, remembering the line of Rupa Goswami or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, observe. And he knows all kinds of siddhanta, expert in all this. But if Krishna Tattva, Maya Tattva, or Rasa Tattva, Bhakti Tattva, Jiva Tattva, is expert. He can only help you, otherwise not. Oh, anyhow, if you have not have a Guru, you are not initiated by such a Guru. You are initiated by family Guru, or the Guru who does not know expertise in Vedas, no realization, is not detached from worldly things. and you are initiated by that guru. But now you are realizing, oh, he cannot help me. I should have the help of any realized soul, having all the qualities, always chanting, remembering, expert in all siddhanta. And especially he should be what? Detached from worldly things. I should go there and I should take his help. He must give help. Will not say that he is my disciple or not. Always ready to help all. So go to them. If better, take him Diksha Guru or Siksha Guru. Both are like same. I know all the disciples of Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj came to Swami Maharaj only for bhakti, not for money, not for good girls, not for anything, wealth and reputation. They left everything behind and serving Swamiji. So, we should always remember this, that if you have left everything for Krishna, what are you doing now? You should always remember. We have come for Krishna service, love and affection. If anyone is helping me out, he is really good. If anyone helping in this object, then he is Guru. And if a person who cannot help in transcendental love and affection of Krishna, then he is not Guru. We should try to become him and to have the association of a high class of exalted and qualified guru. If you are not doing, your purpose will not be solved. You cannot be happy and you cannot have the love and affection of Krishna. Nowadays this is going on. Everywhere. Not qualified guru. Even that they don't know all the siddhanta of Vedas, purport of the Upanishad Gita Bhagavad. No detachment in Dashpat. They initiate any very beautiful girl, like a daughter, and next day what? Marry with him. And makes him what? His wife. What is this silly thing? He is not Guru. At once in a moment we should try to give up this Guru, bogus Guru. In lakhs and lakhs, thousand and thousand births, by the help of these gurus, you cannot. You'll be entangled in Maya, always in Maya. If by fortune A you have initiated by any guru who is sincere and knows something but not detached from worldly things, then what should we do? We should pray him, Prabhu, allow me to have association of that very exalted person. If your guru allows, then you should think that, oh, he is Madhyam Adhikari. And we should try to honor him, but associating with that. Keeping some honor for him. But what doing? Always serving that exalted personality, Gurudev. In any way, like Siksha Guru or Diksha Guru. And he will be ready for this. So you should try. Otherwise, by bogus gurus, or even not bogus, sincere, but he does not know all the process. He is not expert in purport of all the shastra. And if he himself was enjoying something, not detached, oh, he cannot help. So you should know all these things. And then try to do accordingly. Very soon. Otherwise you cannot go up. You cannot be happy. You cannot realize transcendental things. And that is why Raghunath Das Goswami, by his Diksha Guru Jagunandan Acharya, and then by the association of Haridas Thakur, who Brahma and Prahlad mixed. And then he went to Puri. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave his hand in the hands of Sarup Ramodar. And how he was practicing Bhakti Yoga, giving his whole energy in what chanting. Even how we used to do, not taking any delicious preparation. Even Jagannath Prasadam, what doing? Anyhow, rotten Prasadam of Jagannath, washing and giving some salt, to save his life. Whole day long, whole night, not taking any rest, not sleeping, it may be 24 minutes, not more than that. Sometimes, no sleep like this also, and chanting it. Then, what will be? Very soon he realized, and after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sarup Damodar and Gadadhar Pandit, he came to Vrindavan in Radhapur. Why he came? I have not realized anything. So I should die here. How I will die? I should jump in Yamuna. Or I will jump from Govardhan Hill. But what became? Rupa and Sanatan slept there, like Siksha Guru. So Rupa Goswami is the highest Siksha Guru of Raghunath Das Goswami. And now we are in Radhapur, he was chanting and remembering whole day, night, weeping, because how weeping? Hey Radhe, Rajadevi ke jalitke he nanda suna suda. Shiva Vartman Kalpapadamatale Kalipse Bande Goshan Talit Sarvatokhe Dai Mahabipalav Bande. O Krishna, O Radhe, O Lalite, O Vishakhe, bless Lord. On dying, give darshan, give your service. And thus weeping here and there, sometimes in Radhakund, sometimes in Govardhan, sometimes in Nandagaon, sometimes in Vrindavan, sometimes in Vrindavan, Kesi Ghat, Bansi Ghat, all things like this, weeping, weeping. And then his desire was, can you do like this? Even a part, a small part, or that? So this is real process. Without the help of association, anyone can have the love and affection. You know, even trees and creeper can have the mercy of Krishna through high class of devotee. Narad, by association of Narad, Nalkubar and Manigriv, what they became? Associates of Krishna. Even Prahlad, being the son of a very big demon, and he became Prahlad Maharaj to high class Uttam Mahabhagavatam, only by the association of Narada. By the association of Hanuman, Vibhishan, the brother of a very big demon, Raman, he became high class of devotee. So many trees, creepers and all can be
high class of Uttam Mahabhagavat by the high class of association of Vaishnava. So if you want to develop your Krishna consciousness, you should really be sincere and try to associate with high class of devotees, guru, and then you really realize all this. And very quickly you can get it. One thing more. If you have a dog, and giving your some energy to dog, giving the dog some food, some meat, something, you are giving. Dog will be yours. But you will always remember that dog. And maybe in future, at the time of day, you will remember that dog and use the dog. You know Bhart Maharaj? You know the history of Bhart Maharaj? You don't know Bhart. You know Bhart Maharaj? Oh, you should tell the story of Bhart Maharaj. In brief, you should hear all these things and try to develop your Krishna consciousness. Don't waste your energy. Don't waste your time. In proper process, you should try to believe.
In ancient India, there is a great emperor named Bharat Maharaj. When he became middle of his life, then he gave up his kingdom, wife, and children, everyone. But in this world, it is very hard to give up in young age, wife, and children, and kingdom. But he gave up everything and came to the bank of a river to do bhajan. While just doing bhajan, one day he heard that one tiger is roaring and one crow want to jump over the river. She became so fearful, so she jumped over. But before crossing the river, his baby came down from her womb, and going other side, the Joe looked towards her baby deer and sometime looked towards that Bharat Maharaj. Suppose she is telling, oh, can you take care of my baby deer, please? So Bharat Maharaj gave up his bhajan and protect that baby deer. And the Joe expired after 2 minutes. Up to this point he did well. He saved his life and Bhagavan gave him up. But he attained so much. And gradually, the baby deer became grow up. Always he jumped over his lap. Sometime Bharat Maharaj is doing chanting his Gayatri and doing bhajan. The baby deer came from back and asked him to caress him, nourish him. So Bhagavan is giving up bhajan, he wants to nourish and caress him. So one day, in this world he has to give up this material world, he has to give up this body. So the deer, one day one flock of deer came and he mixed with them and ran away from his Bharat Maharaj ashram. So Bharat became so hurry. Where is the deer? He does not know anything. Maybe lion or tiger came and can swallow him. What will be his destiny? So he is searching everywhere. In the meantime, his death came. And he was thinking about deer. So in next birth, he became a deer. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna, Sri Bhagavan Krishna is told, Yang jang vapi smaran bhava tajatante kalevaram. When you are going to die, which you think will be the same species? So Bharata Maharaj was thinking about deer, so he became a deer. But he remembered everything. So he never goes here and there for grazing. Always he stayed here, this is ashram, drink some grass and drink some water from the river. Not mixed with any other deer. He thought, I mixed with the flock of deer, so I became so unfortunate. So I should not mix with them anymore. So when his time came to expire from this world, he prayed God like the language of human beings. After that, he became a Brahmin boy. Being a Brahmin boy, he remembered all things. That he was as before Bharata Maharaj, he was there, he remembered everything. So he became like a dumb. His father wanted to make him utter pranav, means om, want to teach him the best of etiquette. He does not like to learn anything. He knows everything, but externally he is not behaving anything that like a dumb. His father asked him to utter om like this. So his father was very worried. Oh, when I shall pass from this world, who will take care of this boy? So when time came, his father passed away from this world. His brother and sister-in-law, not taking proper care for this Bharat Maharaj, this Jada Bharat. After cooking, there is a husk of that flour and peel of potato and others. They boiled together and served him. He took full stomach and became so happy. And his brother engaged him in the field to protect the grain from the birds. Field this side, he keeping faith other side. So one day, one group of dacoits, they caught one human being, one boy, and they promised, if we get so much oil in rubbing, then we shall cut one human being, and we'll do fire sacrifice in the front of demigoddess Kali, Bhadra Kali. So they caught a boy, but by chance the boy ran away. But that time come for offering fire sacrifice the human being. What to do? Then they went out to find a new person. And they saw one very beautiful and very healthy person sitting on the field. They caught him and he came with them. No opposing, nothing. They feed him, he took full stomach. After that, they put a red cloth on his neck and put him between the two hoofs that they are going to slaughter him. He can come and go in, no problem. Because who did bhajana, who is to do bhajana of Krishna, they are always calm and quiet. They are not worried at all. So he come and quiet. Fire is flaming too much. They are putting ghee and soha. They will chop him and he will offer his head on the fire. When they are about to chop him, in the meantime, there is a tremendous sound came from the deity, from Bhadra Kali. And she took the sword from the dacoits and cut all of them and put on the fire. And she came and hold his hand and make him Bharat Maharaj free and ask, oh Prabhu, don't cheat the world. I know you are a great Vaishnava, and don't cheat others. They could not understand you, they are going to do more offense. So don't cheat anymore. Yes. Bharat Maharaj, come and get you went away. After that, we shall listen from Gurudev.
Thank you.
sense gratification. And within this multiple oh. At the time of death, you remember all these things.
Any you may be
oh.
Fish, dogs, and other things. You are bound to do this. You can test it when you see to chant and remember your Gayatri mantra. In empty mind, then all worldly desires and everything comes in empty mind. You cannot check. So at the time of death, you cannot do anything. Again, you will have to come to this world. Don't think this is our first human birth. Don't think. All lakhs and lakhs, crores and crores. So many that you have taken birth, even in the shape of demigods, even in the shape of demigoddesses. Sometimes dog, hog, pigs, even tree and creepers. But by this time, oh, by the mercy of Krishna, you are like human body. It has given only that you should try to chant and remember Krishna and develop your Krishna consciousness. I'm sending my associates to help you, and you should take help, and very soon you should come to me. But even you are not following, again from long, long births, you will be animals, hogs, pigs, and all these things. So you should try to realize all these facts. I come only to remember you, that you should remember me. Don't give your whole energy in maintaining yourself and being happy in this world. You cannot be by this. So, you should, of a certain number, in certain number, you should chant. What? Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. All you should repeat me. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Even one time you are chanting, it will help you. And if you are with respect and honor, initiated by a high class of devotee, in association of high class of devotees, you are always not wasting your time in other things, even for not even to maintain your life. Oh, Krishna has arranged everything. If you will give up everything for life maintenance, even your life will be maintained. So don't worry for this. And try to develop your Krishna consciousness. Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Sangha. Oh, high class of devotees. We'll give Krishna love and devotion. Oh, by others you cannot have any help. So, remembering this, you should try to change your all things and try to be in the association of what? High class of devotees. They will help you. Otherwise, anyone cannot help you. Your father, mother, brother, even guru, even if he is not expert, he cannot help you. You should try to give your most of your energy and time in Krishna consciousness. If you are serving any bad company even, you are serving or making some what? Life maintenance or some coins or some American dollars, it will not help. Never. You will be happy, not happy. You will have to be dogs and like this.
So why you are not giving energy for Krishna consciousness, not chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Once Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came in the house of Shivash Pandit. He told, "Oh, I know you don't do anything for your maintenance. Always chanting, remember, whole day and whole night. What will be of your maintenance?" Oh, he did like this. One, two, three. What is the meaning? I will start one day chanting, remembering Hare Krishna, Krishna, with big kartals, whole night. And second day also, if not coming anything for my maintenance of life, oh, fasting I will be second day also. And third day. And if fourth day not coming anything, I will jump in Ganges and give up my life. Mahaprabhu told, what? It may be that Lakshmi Devi, goddess of fortune and wealth, oh, he can beg. But my devotees never to die like this. What Nityananda Prabhu has told, yatheshtam re bhrata guru hari hari man manisham tato va samsaram bodhi taradayo vaidya. Oh, Jivas, you should chant loudly, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna
Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
I'm taking your all responsibility that you will be happy. And by chanting, if you are not happy, I'm responsible. So, you should believe on Nityananda Prabhu, words. You can believe in Krishna word. What word? Sarvadharmana paritajyamami ekam saranam praja aham tvam sarva papibho mokshayishyami masucha. What meaning?
Sarvadharman Parichaja, Krishna says, just give up all varieties of duties and religion and other responsibilities that you think you have in this world, Mame Kam Sharanam Raja, and simply surrender to me fully. Come to Vrindavan, come to Braj, and Aham Tam Sarva Papibhyo, I will free you from all of your sinful reactions. You don't have them. You do not have to fear. I will protect you. And even though Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that this is external to pure bhakti, this is a beginning platform, this surrendering process, so that we can go further into the higher realms of Uttama bhakti or pure bhakti.
So, thank you to come here. I'm very grateful to you all. I'm here for 7 days, more than this, 8 days. But I was engaged in writing something very important. It will come forward in front of you as Brahma Sankhita book. Very high class. So I was engaged in writing. And that is why I could not meet you in last 7 or 8 days. But I wanted to meet you very soon. So I told Prabhu that call everyone. Even to whom I don't know, even then, they should be called. I want to meet them and to inspire them in the line of Swamiji. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, to a Prabhupada, in the same line. So, today I am happy. For this purpose I came only to inspire you. Now I am in old age. I want to be in Vrindavan always, chanting, remembering all this there. In the feasts of Srila Govardhan, in Radhaga, in Shamkunda, in Bansibhat, I want to be. But when I remember the orders of our Gurudev, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, my Gurudev, Srila Prabhupada and Rupa Goswami, then I am bound to come to this. So, I think you will help me. Just for chant. If you cannot chant, even one round you should do. But try to give up bad habits like smoking and other things. And then you will see that you are really happy. Your health will be very good by you. And really very soon you will realize that you are happy and find it happy. Go Pramanande.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. I just want to make one announcement. Tomorrow we're going to be having a picnic, transcendental picnic at Kapilani Park. We have some flyers to pass out to everybody. It's going to be a potluck, so we would like everybody who attends to bring some small pot of some prasadam. We'll bring boga. We're going to offer it at the park. And it's going to be from 4 to 6, and we're going to meet somewhere around the bandstand at Kapilani Park. And then the flyers are right here. And then from there, after prasadam, we're going to all march into Waikiki with great Harinam Sankirtan. Hare! For the last 30 weeks, Srila Gurudev's disciples, we have been doing Harinam for the last 30 weeks in a row without missing. We have been performing the Harinam in Waikiki every Saturday. And so tomorrow's New Year's Eve, and we want to make it as big as possible. We want everybody here, everyone, to attend, and even more. We want to really go into Waikiki and give everybody the holy name. And so I just invite everyone to please attend. From 4 to 6 we'll have prasadam, and then after everybody's satisfied, then we'll go into Waikiki. And then also the following day, New Year's Day, we are so fortunate that we get to spend New Year's Day to start off the new year with our Gurudev, Srila Om Vishnu Pada Shishimar Bhaktivedanta Narayan Maharaj. So he'll be blessing us again on Monday. So just want to make the invitation to everybody.
Something to know, they can meet me any day, consulting Brajnath Prabhu and Madhava Maharaj. They can meet me if they want to ask anything.
Monday is probably the last time that Gurudev will speak over here, so if you have friends or anybody that you'd like to invite, please bring them along, and so they can get some special mercy from Gurudev. So I want to encourage everybody. Monday at 5 o'clock. Maui, and then Gurudev will be going to Maui on the 4th. And there'll be programs morning and evening until the night. And that'll be in Kihei. So any of you who can I'll go over there and attend those programs. That'll be very, very good, very nice.